Namaste, I am Chidanand, research scholar from Swasa University, Bangalore. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for giving me the opportunity to speak here. I would like to talk on findings from a pilot project we did at Swasa to see the effect of yoga in diabetics on their cognitive functions. Especially the type 2 diabetes mellitus is associated with cognitive decline and increased risk of developing dementia at later part of the life. Especially type 2 diabetes affects a short time memory, information processing speed, attention, etc. The basic reason is that the hyperglycemia alters the neurovascular coupling. This is a mechanism which involves neurons, vascular components, and other glial cells to provide required energy when there is a neural activation. You mean energy means in the form of oxygen, required nutrients. So, any compromise with respect to this function will affect the cognitive function in an individual. Especially in hyperglycemia, this neurovascular coupling mechanism is compromised, which would result in a cognitive impairment or dysfunction. The compromisation happens in one way of the reduction in oxygen supply to the brain, that means the flow of blood to the brain, the required amount of oxygen, could result in a kind of the decreased cognitive performance. And many studies have shown that exercise, physical activity, especially the aerobic exercises, have a promising results in arresting this kind of cognitive decline or a dysfunction in an old age population or in a morbid situations like diabetes or any other kind of metabolic disorders, obesity or hypertension, etc. And also there are many studies we have seen that yoga is as equal to exercises or even better, or sometimes it is, you know, more effective compared to exercise. And also the more advantage is that it is very safer in old age populations to practice. So with this background, we thought of piloting a project wherein to see the effect of yoga in diabetics on their cognitive functions. And there are many studies done to see the effect of yoga on healthy populations, but not many in diabetics populations. Diabetes being the major risk factor for cognitive impairment as well as dementia. And we have chosen the brain oxygenation is one of the parameter here, especially the oxygenation of the prefrontal cortex, which is responsible for the working memory. And also a performance of a cognitive task through a task called NBAC, wherein we basically measure the accuracy and reaction time. That means how accurate they do the task or how fast they do the task. And also the autonomic variables through electrocardiogram during this cognitive task performance. And as a secondary assessment, we took preservative thinking, which is a kind of repetitive negative thinking normally people undergo in case of diabetes, long-time diabetes, or hypertension, or any other kind of disorders. So which we did through a questionnaire. And we selected 10 participants who came for our in-house health home for a week's treatment for age between 35 to 65 and not having any major complications of diabetes, that is neuropathy, nephropathy, etc. And we had only one group of 10 people doing yoga. And we took two measurements before the start of the treatment and also at the end of the treatment, pre and post study. And this is a 1 week residential program wherein they follow the routine of having yoga practices, meditation sessions, and there will be counseling and also a lecture session. It starts from morning to evening. And yoga practices are specifically for diabetes, and these practices are also recommended by Department of Ayush. And as I mentioned earlier, we are assessing a PFC oxygenation, deoxygenation, and also a working memory task performance. And while doing the task performance, see the effect of autonomic functions to ECG, and through questionnaire, the secondary assessment of preservative thinking. And we use functional near infrared spectroscopy to measure the oxygenation while the subject is undergoing a cognitive task. This works on a basic principle of optics, wherein the oxygen carrying hemoglobins through blood has a different reflection coefficient compared to a hemoglobin which is not carrying oxygen. That is a deoxygenated hemoglobin. With the difference in reflection of near infrared light will indirectly give us a method to calculate the oxygenation in a particular region, brain region, at a particular time. So the results, what we got, bit promising with respect to oxygenation. There's increase in oxygenation in the right, middle, and lateral hemisphere, which linked to an increase in performance of NBAC task, especially in one and two back tasks. And we didn't see any significant, statistical significant results with respect to autonomic functions, ECG characteristics, but we could see an improvement trend. And also the similar results we found during for the preservative thinking. There is a declining trend. We could see quickly the, some of the results what we tabulated here. We did frequency and time domain analysis for ECG, and there's a questionnaire assessments we did. And the mechanism behind this effect of yoga could be explained by physiological and psychological mechanisms. As you know, the yoga brings down the stress level overall, which definitely affects the central nervous system, which has got a link to a cognitive performance in an individual. And also the earlier studies have shown that the yoga practices enhances the neuroplasticity, which is influences the gray matter volume. And also the some of the yoga practices, especially the pranayama, which enhances the cardiovascular fitness of an individual, which in turn influences the cerebral circulation, which ultimately influences the cognitive performance in an individual. So conclusion, what I can say is that our pilot study has shown some results which is promising to take it further. So we need to, we already started a full-fledged project with more samples and having a control group, which is active as well as a passive control like exercise and pure control group, and having a longer period of intervention, which is 3 months of yoga practice. Hope you would be getting a conclusive result with this full-fledged project. That's all from my side. Thanks for your attention and for listening. Thank you. Have a nice day.